Hi, this is Abid Kazmi for Desi TV USA, and here are the major headlines. The spokesman of the governing National League for Democracy said that Myanmar's leaders Aung San and other senior figures from the ruling party were detained by the military officials after a raid. The move came after Myanmar's powerful military triggered worry about a coup last week after threatening to take action over alleged fraud in November elections won by the National League of Democracy. Soldiers were deployed outside the city hall in the main city. The signal for state-run MRTV television dropped in the morning, with the station saying in a Facebook post that it was unable to broadcast due to technical issues. The TV stations later resumed the broadcasting. China's foreign ministry said ahead of a UN Security Council meeting that all actions by the international community should contribute to Myanmar's political and social stability to prevent increasing tensions. The United Nations led condemnation of Myanmar's military after it seized power and called for the release of elected leaders, including Nobel Prize winner Aung San. UN Security General Antonio Guterres said the developments were a serious blow to democratic reforms and urged all leaders to refrain from violence and respect human rights. Military vehicles and soldiers were barricading roads in Myanmar's capital after the military seized power in a coup against the democratically elected government. Civilian cars and motorcycles were forced to turn around after encountering roadblocks manned by armed soldiers as armed vehicles drove by. The army said it has carried out the detentions in response to the election fraud, handing power to the military chief Min Aung Hlaing and imposing a state of emergency. Germany have been hit hard by the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic and have been struggling to survive. Before the COVID-19 epidemic, there were more than 80 open opera houses, an important element of German culture and the country's culture and creative industry. They stage nearly one-third of world's opera performances and attracted enthusiasts from around the world. However, the COVID-19 restriction measures since last year forced many opera houses to close. When the pandemic became less severe, the opera houses tried to stage live performances in empty parking lots with a maximum audience of 200. But the pandemic became serious later and the parking lot show was also suspended again.
Thank you for watching. For more news and updates, please click on our link tree.